one area or factor also being considered in that report is contract enforcement, and they are concerned, especially the foreign investors here, about the slow judicial process or corruption among certain number of judges. Do we have a way out?
Well, if you would notice, well, we have Chief Justice Hilario Davide, who in the recent past, in fact, have been suspending or firing erring judges. And there's a judicial academy which has been there. They're trying to improve. It takes a little time, but even our judicial system, especially under the leadership of Justice Larry David, is doing its best to improve the administration of justice.
If an investor had a list of his concerns in the country or in the Philippines before investing, how would political instability rank in that list, probably?
I don't understand.
Well, right now, DTI had to send a high-level delegation to several countries to reassure investors that were about to come in, but decided to put their project on hold because of what's happening now. So that's how important it is. I think eventually we'll get over this and things will settle down and all of these people will start coming into the country once again.
If I may add, Yvette, as I said, it's a matter of perception from reality. And so those that are already here, they say they're not bothered by it. In fact, I'd like to quote the chair of one of the locators inside the zone, and he was asked, why are you so bullish in putting more investments in that country when there are daily rallies or whatever? And he said, you know, in any given rally demonstration, you can be assured of 100% attendance of our workers in my facility as compared to an ordinary blizzard in Philadelphia, where you can expect about one-third cannot make it to the factory. So, but I agree with the boy Fulgencio here that for those who don't know about the reality, they may withhold or they may put on hold or maybe think twice in investing in the country.
It's time to have some questions from the audience.
What is blocking schools and colleges from offering online e-learning degree programs?
What's blocking schools from offering online e-learning degree programs?
Distance education is the wave of the future, and there's no way we can start, we can stop it from coming over. So, and let me also say that the information and communication technology services sector is one of the strengths of the Philippine economy. So I cannot understand why the Philippines is not taking advantage of distance learning as a way of propagating education in the country.
Yes, I agree with Boy. There's a need for us to do this because we are a country of 7,200 islands. And this is the easiest, fastest way to get to all our population, educate them. So if there's something wrong with the law, maybe amend it and implement it fast so that we would be with the mainstream of our other Asian neighbors.
Actually, the chair, there's some rent-seeking regulations banning schools from offering online e-learning unless they have the obsolete or irrelevant level 3 accreditation. This is the main obstacle to the offering of the online e-learning. The CHED officials are afraid that it might cause unemployment of the present teachers because they might be replaced by computers.
It's true. And then you have the issue, though, is when you have skilled graduates and then they end up leaving the country to look for better opportunities. But you were telling me earlier in PEZA alone, what is your employment rate like?
We have now over 1 million employed in these 75 economic zones all over the country.
1 million?
Yes, including IT parks and IT companies.
Okay, all right. And I mean, is employment for you an issue in terms of the type of opportunities that employees really have here?
Well, in terms of opportunities, I think in the future, the opportunities will really center on the ICT services sector, call centers, BPOs, and so on and so forth.
Okay.
So we need to I think what we need to do is to tailor our curriculum to fit the needs of industry, not the other way around.
Okay. And if I may add, maintain our English proficiency, because as Boy said, this is the wave of the future, and we need to have good English-speaking operators. We used to dominate this, but I think gradually we are going down the line. So I think there's been some concerted efforts already to maintain our English proficiency and dominancy in this part of the world.
And we'd like to thank our guests very much for coming over. Attorney Lilia De Lima, who is the Director General of the Philippine Economic Zone Authority, and Virgilio Fulgencio, who is the Executive Director of the DTI Center for Industrial Competitiveness. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we will be right back. You are engaged in Public Policy Forum and ANC and International Academy of Management and Economics Special.
On our 154th year anniversary, we at BPI thank you for making us a part of your life. BPI, 154 years of making banking history.
From our discussion, we now recommend the removal of barriers to growth, the simplification of business regulations, the creation of a single access point, and in the field of education, repeal rent-seeking irrelevant regulations on third-level accreditation which bar e-learning online institutions from producing trade services